Oh, you have your camera on.
I always have a camera.
Okay.
So did you sit over here with him?
Yes, it was.
I gotta sit next to her again.
Again. Yep.
It is my seat anyway.
Oh yeah.
Okay, what's up?
So I'm here with Mr. and Mrs.
Canelo.
And your heritage came over from what part of Italy?
His family comes from Bari.
Uh-huh.
And my family comes from Avigliano.
Avigliano?
Yes.
Avigliano.
Okay, so you're a second generation Italian.
First generation.
You came over on the boat?
No. Sorry, I'd be second generation.
Second generation, okay, right. So your parents came over first.
Yeah,
right?
Both right. Of our parents, yes.
So what year did your parents go? Did they tell you?
I don't know much about his family, but I would assume that my mother got here maybe 1919.
Okay.
She was 16 years old.
Okay.
She was born 1903, I think, if I remember. My father came around 1921.
Okay.
But I don't know much about
No, I don't know what year
he came.
Well, I would say similar years to Zahara's.
Okay, and they both came through Ellis Island?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. And they settled where?
My mother settled in Jersey City. I think my father settled in New York.
Okay.
She had somebody that would brought her over.
All right. And
gave
your
her
parents?
A job.
My father got a job in Horn and Harder.
Oh, okay.
You know,
the sandwich place.
Yeah, right.
That's
where
he worked.
Stuff like that. Right. And then he migrated to Englewood or Edgewood.
I don't know.
And from there, I don't remember. I don't know.
Yeah.
Now,
and
the family owns a business, or used to own a business.
The Canillos? Yeah.
The mentioned La Fede.
Oh, La Fede, yeah. But the Canillos, his brothers and nephews first started in Italian Deli in West New York.
All right.
And after that, they purchased a warehouse in Passaic.
Right.
And they kept that business for quite a long time. They just sold it maybe 4 years ago.
Right.
4 or 5 years ago.
And what type of business was it?
Italian warehouse food.
Yeah.
Imported and export, I guess.
Okay.
Whatever. But it's Hurricane Sandy did them in.
Ah.
You know.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, people couldn't pay the bills from South Jersey. They ordered the food, but all their businesses went out.
Right.
And they didn't have the money to pay them back.
Well, I understand.
Can I tell you a very funny incident
in
the warehouse?
I love to hear it.
Okay. One day they had a fire in the warehouse, and the heat cooked all the pasta that was right?
Right.
It almost exploded in the way.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they had like a central sprinkling system.
Right.
Yeah.
And a fire, and it cooked all the pasta.
Yeah.
So the way the insurance company evaluated it, they took a measurement from the height of the pasta and the base of the pasta, and they figured out roughly how many boxes of
pasta. That is funny.
It is, yeah.
So now, your parents came over here in the teens, so that means neither one of them were old enough to fight in World War One. Your father wasn't old enough?
Was your father in? My father was in World War One.
He was in World War One?
Yeah, my father was.
I don't think he was in act. I don't think they were in active. I don't remember saying anything.
Oh, okay.
In active duty. But I remember him mentioning it, that he had been there. Yes.
Okay, so.
My father was in the cavalry, just like I was in the cavalry.
Okay.
It was oddly enough, yeah.
All right. So was that World War One or World War Two?
One.
Okay.
One.
So then it means?
They were still in Italy at the time.
Were you in World War Two?
No.
No. No, because you came after that, right?
No,
No, he's after the Korean War.
Okay.
My brother almost went to the Korean War. Oh,
okay.
He went into service 1957.
57 to 59. So I pulled border duty in Czechoslovakia and Germany.
Oh, okay.
And that was our thing. And then when Khrushchev came around, we were waiting ready for the enemy, for the Russians to come over. You know, so we were waiting for them.
It seems like a gap there. Your father was in World War One, and that was like 1918.
Yeah, and
you must have been born a lot later.
Oh yeah.
Well, we're both born 1937.
Ah, that's why.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Mhm. That's cool. So now, when you were born in what city?
Jersey City.
Jersey City. How old was Jersey City?
In
back
the home.
Then?
In a home.
In the
on
home.
On Danforth Avenue. Yeah, I wasn't born in a hospital.
Yeah. No. No. You know, I mean, yeah. I'm,
were you born in a hospital?
No, in a hospital.
Yeah.
I was uppity.
He was. I was brought up in a projects. He was brought up in a one-family house.
Okay, which projects were there?
In Lafayette Gardens, what? Jersey City.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now, what was the makeup of the projects then? What was the most extra group in the project?
It was a mixture.
Yeah?
A mixture, yes. It was white.
Okay.
All right. If you cross the street. Yeah, had the black projects so across the street. That's how
it was segregated on purpose that way? Or?
Remember, I'm sure it will. Yeah. I'm sure projects. Yeah, I don't the black people in our projects.
What was it about? And yeah. What was some of your memories going to school?
I enjoyed
like that.
Growing up in I'd always growing along project. Six really? Play in the morning, day long, out. In fact, 30 and that I grew up, I was living in. Right now, I have a friend people living up with Redding, right? Fort Redding. Mm-hmm. Now, two people just playing in Fort. It's out 6 days now. A little quarter and we nine. I was 32 time I went up to nine. This was when my mother on a for lunch. And she called me upstairs for dinner. The call
was like,
we had a time. Yeah. A lot of kids we could play with. Had a good, you know, a lot of people, good kids.
Where did you two?
You know, was there?
Jersey City.
Yeah? Me.
Me and Jersey.
Sorry.
It's Fawn Pond. We didn't Staten Island.
Oh.
Well, I knew his family. Before I knew him. I knew his brother. Was all his brothers. That's because he was never born. Right? Yes. Yeah. But it was very sweet. We ended up both living on Stegman Street. I lived on Stegman Parks. And every time I would pass his house, but I still didn't know him, his father, a lovely person. I had to go and get a bus to go back to the Lafayette Gardens to the butcher my mother was so used to.
Uh-huh.
And every time I'd come back, his father would have a bouquet of flowers.
Oh.
From the rose, from his garden for me, yeah, yeah. Yeah, he knew us, we knew each other. We knew his aunt and uncle very well, cousins and everything. But I didn't know him until we met at Wolf Palm Park in Jersey. He didn't date me the first year. Because he thought I was an older woman. Right?
Not really.
Yes, he thought I was few years older.
I thought you were older, but I wasn't ready to date.
Yeah.
And I wasn't looking to get married or anything. Just,
yeah. Oh, okay. What year was this?
1955. We started dating in 56. We went back to Wolf's Farm Park, and we saw each other again.
Okay.
And that's when we started dating.
So you started dating before you went in the military?
Right.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I waited
for him. She waited for me.
For 2 years, yeah.
And she met me 2 years later when I came back on the troop ship.
Off the troop ship.
Okay.
That was very nice to see. All the soldiers coming off the ship were kissing the ground.
Ah.
They were so happy to be back in the USA. Yeah.
So you got off the troop ship and you proposed immediately, right?
Yeah, we got engaged right away.
Pretty much so.
Yeah,
pretty much
September.
So. Or was it a little later?
Yeah, that September we got married the following May.
I figured we're married. If she would wait for me that long, and I would definitely marry that woman. Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yeah.
So what about her attracted you to her?
I don't. In Wolf Pond Park, I just happened to. I had my brother with me. We're going to float a
the
little
younger brother,
toy yeah. boat.
Uh huh.
With him. And I didn't want to go that day. My parents begged me to drive them over there so they can have a day out. And I finally agreed. So we're going to float this little boat. I happened to look up and I seen it and I went, boing! And that's the truth. It was like, wow. I had no intention of ever getting married or anything like that. But when I seen her, she was for me.
Okay, I'll tell you what attracted him to me.
What's that?
He made me laugh.
Ah.
I was a quiet, little, you know, very shy. And he brought, yeah, I know, she's lit. I'm not like that anymore.
No.
But he brought everything out.
He used to be happy.
Yeah.
You used to be happy. He's still a comedian, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's it. That's really it.
Well,
somebody I was easy to talk to. I didn't have, you know, I was very comfortable with him. And that was it. And I wasn't supposed to be at Wolf's Farm Park that day. It's a little longer story. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Go ahead.
Okay. My friend Mary asked me to go down to Seaside Heights with her and her family. So I wanted to go. I begged my mother, oh, please, Emma, please let me go. I'll be open. Say the mother, my father is there. Everything is going to be fine. Okay, you can go. I'm going about my first meal. The I got they sorry for you. First meal served me. That is this cold soup boy.
That's it.
You know what that is? It's a beating meat.
I know that.
Pito, and that boiled, their feet, raw oil. Top of it, he said, I'll go home, I'm which I just want. I sort of told my mother, I want to come home. I don't want to ask, what's the matter? I said, I can go home, a cousin is coming back. And she said, okay. So I went home the next morning and I get up. My mother says the same thing his mother says. Come on, let's go to Wolf's Pond Park. You're not doing anything. And, you know, at that age, you don't want to be seen dead with your parents.
Right.
You know, on a Sunday, you know. And I went. That's how we met. And we started dating steadily. That was 61.
It was meant to be.
Destiny.
Yeah. Destiny. That's right.
And we're married 57 years now.
57
years.
Yeah.
We met 61 bliss. Years ago. Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Again, I used to be happy.
He's a joker.
Well, it's a little harder now.
That's great. That's
it's a little hard.
That's great.
We just can't hear each other. You know?
Okay, yeah.
What'd you say?
So what would you like to say to the newlywed daughter and her husband as a well wish as well as advice on how to continue their lives together and hopefully emulate your years of marital bliss?
No, I really think I even said it to her recently. I think that communication is very, very important. And wait, there's the other word. And I can't think of the word.
Well,
communication and compromise. I think compromise is extremely important.
I
see how we get along all these years. Let's say I want to go see an opera. He'll go. He don't want to see opera. He'll go. He wanted to go fishing. I went fishing with him. I just hold the reel. I didn't put the worm or whatever it is on it. Nothing. So I think that, you know, you have to. And I think also for my daughter, her husband is very into the violin. And I think he enjoys very much going to these gigs. I think she's going to have to be patient.
Oh, yeah. No,
patient
he's
with that.
More
I really
than
do.
Happy. He's more than willing.
But he seems like he's a nice, even-tempered person.
Say, stay but, best friends and don't keep any guns in the house.
There's truth to that. There are days.
I have no problem with him going out.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you know, he really enjoys, you see how much he really, really, he really enjoys that. So that's a way of keeping him happy, you know, contented, you know. He worked, when we first got married, he had 3 jobs. He worked 6.5 days a week. And what we did was, well, especially because of this block, we were here 51 years ago, we moved here.
Wow.
And we were friends. We're on Friend Street. I don't know if you noticed.
Yeah.
We were all friends on Friend Street. We went out on Saturday night dancing, having a nice time, which helped you, him especially, look forward at least the next week, not come home and sit here and there's nothing to life except work.
Right.
We tried to avoid that.
Well, I'll tell you, 57 years together, still going strong.
Yeah.
beautiful children.
When the moon hits
they
your
tell,
eye like
there's
a
saying that you can tell how well
water.
You did your job as a parent when you see
when the world seems to shine like you've had too
oh,
much
children,
wine. That's more.
But yeah,
bells will ring,
yeah,
ting-a-ling-a-ling, ting-a-ling-a-ling,
and you'll
sing the bella. Hearts will play tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay, like a guitarandella. When the stars make you drool, just like a pastifazool, that's amore. When you dance down the street with a clod at your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. Excuse me, but you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore.
When the world seems to shine like you've had too much wine, that's amore.
That's amore.
Bells will ring,
ding-a-ling-a-ling,
ding-a-ling-a-ling,
and you'll sing Vita Bella.
Vita Bella, Vita Bella. Hearts will play,
tippy-tippy-tay, tippy-tippy-tay,
like a gay tarantella.
Lucky fella.
Like pasta, fuzzle,
that's amore.
That's amore.
When you dance down the street with the cloud at your feet, you're in love. When you walk in a dream, but you know you're not dreaming, signore. But you see, back in old Napoli, that's amore,
amore,
that's amore.